You're watching CBS 3 Springfield.
Thank you. Well, let's go one-on-one now. The Massachusetts Nurses Association has collected 50,000 signatures to get two initiatives on the November ballot. Here to talk more about those initiatives is Sandra Houghton, an operating room nurse at Mercy Medical Center and MNA board member. Thank you, Sandra, for being here.
You're welcome. Thank you.
So for people at home that may not have been following this, for the past 13 years, you say, you've been trying to get these two initiatives through the legislature.
Correct.
Can you talk about what those mean for people out there?
Well, the Patient Safety Act is for patient safety. You know, there's been numerous, multiple researches done on the number of patients that a nurse has and the mortality, morbidity of those patients. And the less patients that she has, the mortality and morbidity also decrease.
Right, so that act would it mandate how many patients that a nurse would care for? How would
there's
that work?
A little bit of flexibility in there, but yes, it would it would encourage and mandate a certain number for certain areas, like one-on-one in the ICU, depending on the critical nature of the patient. PACU has certain standards. The post-anesthesia care unit also has standards. Would be one for an intubated patient, one to two for, you know, non-intubated, but, you know, freshly out of surgery.
Sure.
One to four for med-surg.
And I understand the other initiative would actually make it where you want to see actually the profits more transparently from hospitals. Can you talk about that initiative?
Well, I think most hospitals, you know, across the state and across the United States receive federal and local, you know, state funds, you know, to run the hospitals. And a lot of hospitals are, you know, running their hospitals on 50% their income is from state and federal dollars between Medicare and Medicaid. And I think people have a right to know where their dollars are going, and, you know, how much the CEOs are making. Are they putting a lot of that profit that they're making back into, you know, things for the patients that would make, you know, patient safety better, or just more access for patients, or, you know, a greater access to, you know, to patients, you know, for different, well, like Cooley Dick Partners. Made $350 million profit last year, and yet they closed the pediatric unit at Cooley Dick. Now, I think some of that $350 million probably could have saved that unit and allowed that those people from Northampton and some of the surrounding areas, you know, to keep their children in a community that they know and feel safe and comfortable in.
Right, and Sandra, I also want to talk a little bit about the opposition that you guys do face, the Massachusetts Medical Association speaking out, sort of saying they're against the initiatives. How do you respond to that?
Well, the Mass Medical Association has never been pro the safe staffing initiatives or patient care, safe patient care initiatives. And, you know, a lot of it is, you know, they're doctors, they're not nurses, some of them are administrators, and, you know, I think they have more to do with the administration of the hospitals. I think when you talk one-on-one to some of the doctors and surgeons, you know, they'll tell you that, you know, they do need more nurses for their patients, but that it's, you know, when it comes to, you know, speaking out against administrations, they're a little bit less apt to do that.
All right, Sandra Houghton, thank you so much for being
here. Thank you
so
much.
We'll continue to follow the story.
All right, thank you so much.
Appreciate it.